So hello there Akai fans, here we have my serviced Akai GX-M50 3 head cassette deck. I replaced the belts and the pinch roller, also completely stripped down the mechanism and cleaned all of the idlers, which are in pretty good condition. All I done with the idlers was get a big pencil eraser and clean the rubber with the pencil eraser, and they come up nice and supple. So that's all done. The next job I wanted to do once I set it up with hi-fi was to adjust the bias. Now, the bias, master bias for a type 1 cassette, better be careful there, I've got this live, I'm so close to the mains there. That is the master bias for the right channel and the left channel, so that is for the type 1 position. Now that, I've fine-tuned that, I only do this by ear. There's a couple of tracks I listen to and adjust this by ear, connect it to the hi-fi, and I just twiddle them until I prefer the sound. Obviously comparing it between the source and the tape recording, I just find that's easier. I go by my ears, not necessarily by an oscilloscope or a voltmeter. So secondly, the next job are these ones here, these pots down here. Now the one at the top of the triangle, that fine tunes the bias for the chrome setting. The one at the top there fine tunes the bias for the old low noise high output cassettes, which are pretty much obsolete. And the one at the bottom there is for metal. Now I use three types of cassette. Good old TDK D series. Now this other one here, that is actually brand new ferric tape. I don't know what kind of ferric tape it is, but it's come from a company called Tapeline in the UK. It's got quite a few of these in stock. It's basically old shells loaded with C60 type 1 tape, and the type 1 tape is brand new. So what I'm intending to do, what I've done, is adjusted the bias on the old low noise high output setting for this particular cassette. So that is on the obsolete low noise high output. And this one at the bottom here, again, it's brand new tape, which is apparently Bassef Superchrome. It's brand new, loaded into brand new clear shells. Again, from a company called Tapeline. I use quite a few of these. So that's what I've done. The first position on here, low noise, that is for the standard TDK D series. The LH is for that reel-to-reel type one cassette. I've adjusted that, and obviously the chrome position I've adjusted for the Bassef Super Chrome. The metal, I'm still yet to get some metal tapes, but again, this company called Tapeline produces metal tapes in their own shell, and I believe it's loaded with Max L metal tape. He sells these for about £4.50 a piece, so again, they're pretty good. So I'm going to switch to the low noise high output position, which I've calibrated for the reel to reel type cassette. And let's put it in. I've got a track lined up on the Apple TV. It's by Paul Young, and there's lots of S's in there. So if you've overdone it with the bias and it's slightly on the bright side, then the S's will distort. So it's a good track to use to compare the sound. So here we go. Right, so let's switch over to the source. Excuse me, I'm doing this on an iPhone. Not you're going to hear the difference. So that's the source. You've been with him, now you come back, my lady. Dolby's off. We're gonna go to space. Like? I just watch the ocean by myself. Back to tape. Back to source, rather. Dolby's pretty good on this deck as well. So there we go, I'm pretty pleased with that.
It's a crappy iPhone camera, so the sound quality is not going to be brilliant. But there we go. Just show you my system. I'm using B&W DM330 speakers. I've put them on their own floor spikes. There's the other one there. And there's the setup. DL103 on the turntable. Akai GX625. There's the old where the tape deck come from. Tuner, amplifier. And I've got a, at the minute, an old Philips. I think it's a CD650. So there we go. I've also got another one of these GX-M50s in the kitchen, which a belt kit has just arrived. And as soon as I get the time, I shall be refurbing that one as well. So there we go, Akai fans. Speak to you soon.